Now we have to discuss delta connected supply system. So here this is the delta connected system, and we have supply system and we have load connected load. Okay, so this is phase, another phase, this is another phase. So this is the current, for example IR, this is IY, this is IB, and the current, line current is nothing but IL1, IL2, IL3. So IL1, IL2, IL3 are nothing but line currents. So this is IR, IY, IB are nothing but phase currents. And so from here to here, this is phase voltage VR, this is phase voltage VB, and this is phase voltage, this is VY, VB. So we have line currents, phase currents, phase voltages, and then line voltage is nothing but what? This is VRY, this is VYB, and this is VBR. So in this case, first we have to write the phase voltages, which is equal to VR. So VR is a phase voltage. VY, which is equals to VY, which is equals to VB, which is equals to V phase, right? Like this, line voltages, here VR is equals to VY is equals to VB is equals to V phase, means what? Magnitude is same, but the angle is 0 degrees, minus 120, minus 240, that is the difference, okay? Next, line voltages, here, line voltage is nothing but VRY, which is equals to VYB, which is equals to VBR, which is equals to VL, line voltages. So in this case, see, from here to here, this is phase voltages. What about VRY? From this point to this point. So this point to this point means what? This point. From this point means this point. So between these two, we have line voltages. Again, between these two, we have phase voltages. So VR is present between these two nodes. Again, the line voltage is also present between these two nodes, right? So this is VRY, which is present between these two nodes. This is phase voltage, which is present between these two nodes. So in this case of delta connected supply system, the line voltage, which is equals to phase voltage. So same voltage across these two points, that's it. So in case of delta connected supply system, the line voltage equals to phase voltages. But in case of star connected supply system, line current equals to phase current, but there is a difference in voltages. But in case of delta connected system, there is same voltages of line and phase, but there is difference in case of currents, that is line currents and phase currents. So here, this is node R, node Y, node B. So by KCL, at this node C, at node R, what is the incoming current is IR, IL1 is nothing but outgoing current, IB is nothing but outgoing current. So incoming current is IR, outgoing current is IL1 plus IB. So like this, for at this node, IY is incoming, at this node, IY is incoming, IR is outgoing, and again IL2 is outgoing. So IL2 plus IR, like this, IB, towards IB is incoming current, IY is outgoing, again IL3 is outgoing. So IL3 plus IY. So from this, IL1 is nothing but what? IR minus IB. The line current IL2 is what? IY minus IR. From this, IL3 is what? IB minus IB. So these are very important observations. So based upon these equations, we have to draw the phasor diagram. So consider lagging load. Again, I am going to consider the lagging load. Later, I am going to explain the simple trick to draw the phasor diagram, that is RL load, okay? That is, first we have to draw the phase voltages, that is VR, VY, VB. Clear? Next, this is phase. In case of delta, phase is equals to line, right? Next, see the load. The load is lagging load. Always the current lags phase voltage by some angle. So always this is the phase current IR. The phase angle is phi. So this is I by this is I B. So phase voltages, phase currents completed. Okay. Next, we have to draw the line currents. That is IR minus IB. Here we have IR, positive IR. We do not have minus IB. That is, this is positive IB. So this is minus IB, right? In between these two, we have to get this is IL1. IL1. So between these two, we have 60 degrees. So this is 30 degrees. Same like in case of star connected supply system. So in between IR and minus IB, we have what? IL1. In between IY and minus IR, this is IY. This is IR. So in between these two, we have IL2. In between these two, we have what? IL3. Completed. The phasor diagram is completed. First, you have to draw the phasor, phase voltage, then current, again IL1, line current. That's it. See, from this, the line current IL1 is equals to IL1 is nothing but IR square mod IR square plus mod IB square plus 2 into mod IR mod minus IB cos 60 degrees, right? So IR is nothing but what? Phase current. So I phase square plus I phase square plus 2 into I phase into I phase into cos 60, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 2 to cancel, which is equals to square root of 3 I phase square, which is equals to IL. So from this, IL is equals to root 3 I phase square. So from this, IL is equals to root 3 I phase. IL is equals to root 3 I phase. In case of star connected supply system, VL is equals to root 3 V phase. Here, IL is equals to root 3 I phase. And VL is equals to V phase. What about power, which is equals to 3 into V phase I phase cos phi. Here 3 into what is phase voltage, which is equals to line voltage. What about phase current, IL by root 3. Then substitute IL by root 3 cos phi, which is equals to root 3 VL IL cos phi kilowatts. Same value of voltage we are going to get in case of delta connected supply system. Again, sorry, delta. What is reactive power, which is equals to again root 3 VL IL sin phi R 3 V phase I phase sin phi. What about apparent power? 3 V phase I phase, this is kVAr, this is kVA. Angle between line current and phase current. Line current and phase current is what? 30 degrees. So, this is line current, phase current, 30 degrees. Next, angle between line current and line voltage is 30 plus 5, 30 plus 5. And what is third observation? VL is equals to V phase, IL is equals to root 3 I phase. So, this is the third observation. So, this is about delta connected supply system.